Hi students, welcome back to BankExamsToday.com, and today we are going to do one of the very important chapter from reasoning ability, that is blood relations. So in the exams you will find two or three questions from blood relation chapter in almost SBI, IBPS, every exam, RBI, LIC. But in some of the exams there are puzzles, right? In reasoning there are puzzles, and those puzzles are based upon this concept, blood relations. Most of the time the concept is somewhat similar, you know, the husband A is the wife of B, B is the son of C, how A and B is an engineer, D is a doctor. They make it somewhat complicated, but the concept is same. The concept is related to blood relation only. You can use the similar concept, same concept in reasoning puzzles. So I'm not going to tell you what are the various relationships there is, a father and son, what is the father-in-law, what is the sister-in-law. You should I assume that you are aware about those relations. If you are not aware about those relations, I'm going to give you a link. Go to this link and read that article that I have posted on BankExamsToday.com. So now I'm going to give you a simple trick how to solve the blood relation questions. The trick, I assume that there are two types of gender. The first one is male and the second one is female. In that blood relation chapter, I assume that there are two types of genders, male and female. I'm just leaving out the transgenders, So male and female, to depict male, I give it a symbol plus, and to depict female, I give it a symbol minus. This is a very, masculine approach. Many people won't like why I'm giving the minus symbol. If you want to use any other symbol, not the plus, minus, or multiply, or divide, you can use that, but that seems to be very easy for me. I'm using plus symbol for male, minus symbol for female. That is the first step. Then how we are going to solve the question, we'll be making a table, a kind of a chart, a family chart to solve the question. So as in a family chart, each generation will be in a single line. For example, there is a father, right, and there is a son, right, and there is his son named X. So F is the grandfather of X. That's how we do this question. That is the first generation, second generation, third generation, right? That's how we do the question. And secondly, for example, F is the father of S. F is a father, so that's why we'll give the plus symbol to F. S is a son, so it's also a plus symbol. X is the son of S, so it's also a plus symbol. Then if F is having a second son named as U, so what their relationship will be depicted by this, a simple arrow, right? That's how we depict their relation. But in case you want to depict another relation, a husband-wife relation, we'll give something like W. For example, W is the wife of S. She is the wife, so we'll give it a minus symbol. Just give them two arrows, right? That's how we are depicting the husband and wife relation, and that's how we are depicting the brother and sister relations, right? The brother's relation, if F is having another daughter, then we can depict it as minus. And similarly, so V is a sister of U. So if there is a double arrow, then that depicts that these are husband and wife. But as there is a single arrow, she is the sister. So that's how we are going to solve all the questions related to blood relations, right? Just give it a look. Now let's do the first question, our first question. You'll see the captions in the video related to this first question, so don't worry about that. Pinky, who is Victor's daughter, will in the exams most of the intelligent people are not going to make these graphs, but they'll make these graphs in their brain. But to explain you the simple concept, and even if you're trying these questions at your home, try 20-30 questions by making graphs. After that 20-30 questions mark, you can just try that mental calculation, draw these graphs on your mind. But as of now, do like this. Pinky, who is Victor's daughter? There is Mr. Victor. Who's the daughter of Victor? Okay. There's a generation gap. She is the daughter. We'll give it a minus symbol. Says to Lucy, Pinky, who is Victor's daughter, say to Lucy. Pinky say to Lucy, Your mother Rosie. We'll make another graph. Lucy. Who's Lucy's mother? Your mother Rosie. She is a mother, so give it minus. Is the younger sister of my father. Similarly, is the younger sister of my father. Okay, now we got to know that Victor is a male. We are not going to assume who is male or who is female just by their name. Now, Pinky said, my father's younger sister. Then this goes to be plus. Victor's is plus, then he's a male. Who is third child of Joseph? Now there is in sabke papa, Joseph. Then Mr. Joseph, who is third child of Joseph? He is a son of Joseph. She is a daughter of Joseph. And there is a third child. There is another child, I don't know who is he. Leave it. How is Joseph related to Lucy? Mr. Joseph and there's Lucy. How they're related? Obviously, that Miss Rosie is the daughter of Mr. Joseph and Lucy is the daughter of Rosie. Then how they're related? Simply, Joseph is the grandfather of Lucy. Simple. That is the simplest question. You are not going to see these kind of questions in exams, but I'm explaining you the concept. That's why I picked the simplest question from the book. And yes, do not follow R.S. Agarwal book. That Reasoning Ability by R.S. Agarwal. Do not follow that book. You are going to find these type of questions in that book. You will find 70-80 questions, these type of questions from that book. I don't recommend that book at all. Let's do the second question. Mohan is the son of Arun's father's sister. Mohan, here is Mr. Mohan. And he is a son of, here is Mr. Arun. Arun's father. Name is not given. We'll assume that Arun's father is X. Give it a plus. He's a father, so it's a plus. Arun's father's sister. Let's give Arun's father's sister a name, that is XS, father's sister. Give it a minus symbol. And Mohan is the son of. Mohan is a son, so it's a plus. Prakash is the son of Reva. Prakash is the son of. This statement is not related to this graph. So we are making another graph. Prakash is the son of Reva. Who is the mother of Prakash is the son of Reva. Who is the mother of Vikas and grandmother of she is a mother. Reva is a woman. Who is the mother of Vikas and grandmother of Arun? So Arun, here comes Arun, here is Arun and here is Arun. Okay. Reva is the wife of Pranab. How is the wife of Vikas related to Neela? So let's, you know, combine these graphs. So how we can do that? First of all, Arun is a point, is a main point that relate these two graphs. So how we are going to relate this, you know, here is Arun. Arun's father is P. So that X is P. That is not X, he got his name. That is P. P is Prakash. That is Prakash. We are joining these two tables. And then Reva is the mother of Prakash. Reva, can you see this support to this point? I don't think so. Reva is a mother of Prakash. Then who's the husband? Prakash is the son of Reva. Who's a mother? Pranab is a father, is a wife of Pranab. And there is Mr. Pranab, who's husband, Mr. Husband. You know, we got two P's, then Pranab. Okay, then here is Mr. Vikas. Okay, now we don't need this graph, we just put, I have put all the values from this graph to this, to the main graph. So let's delete this. I remove this. So now we have completed this graph. Now, how is the wife of Vikas is related to Neela? Who's the Vikas mother? Pranab is the father of Neela. Pranab is the father of Neela. Again, I missed something. Pranab is the father of Neela and the grandfather of Mohan. I just missed this. The mother, Prakash is the son of mother. Pranab is the father of Neela. Pranab is the father of Neela. Pranab is the father of Neela and the grandfather of Mohan. Okay, we got this value too. We got the XS value. We got this value. Right? And these two people are brothers and sisters, you know, as I hope you are clear about that. These three people are, you know, brothers and sisters. So how Vikas, where is Vikas? Vikas, how Vikas is related to Neela? How is the wife of Vikas is related to Neela? Obviously, these two are brothers and sisters. Vikas is the brother of Neela. So how Vikas wife is related to Neela? She is the sister-in-law of Neela. That's it. Simple. This chapter may seem to be difficult, but it is not. Okay, let's do another question. T, S and R are three brothers. Let's draw it instead of, you know, speaking order. Let's draw it. T, Mr. S and Mr. R. These are three brothers. T's son Q is married to K. T's son Q. Yeah, brothers, so give it plus. T's son Q is married to K. Double arrow because he's married. They have one child, Rahul, blessed to them. Okay. M is a son of S. Who is married to H? And this couple is blessed with a daughter, Madhavi. R has a daughter, N. Who is married to P? I hope you can read this up to this point. Yes, you can.
This couple has one daughter, Karuna.
This couple has one daughter, Karuna.
Bond them. How Madhavi is related to S? How Madhavi
is related to S?
Obviously, she's, granddaughter. Madhavi is the granddaughter of S. There is a one generation gap. Madhavi is the daughter of M, and M is the son of S. So she's the granddaughter of S. Simple.
That is a simple question.
That's it. Let's do another question. I hope you the concept is very clear to you. Whenever there is a male, give it a plus symbol. Whenever there is a woman, give it a minus symbol. A one line for a brother-sister relation. And double line for a husband-wife relation. And there's a vertical line for, the generation gap. There's a father and a son. Then there is, give it a vertical line, That's how we are going to solve the next question. Aarti and Saurabh are the children of Mr. and Mrs. Shah.
There is Mr. Shah and Mrs. Shah. Give it a plus. SHX. Okay. Mr. and Mrs. Shah.
Aarti and Saurabh.
Aarti and Saurabh.
They are the children of Mr. and Mrs. Shah. And Ritu and Shakti are children of Mr. and Mrs. Mehra.
Ritu and Shakti. Mr. Mehra. Then Mrs. Mehra. Mr. Mehra, Ritu. Ritu and Shakti.
Saurabh and Ritu are married to each other. Saurabh and Ritu.
Okay, they got married. Double lines.
Saurabh and Ritu are married to each other. And two daughters, Mukti and Shruti, are born to them.
Two daughters, Mukti and Shruti,
born to them. Shakti is married to Reena.
I just got confused here. I think here is Aarti and Saurabh. I should give it a different name. Ritu and Shakti. Shakti.
Similar names are there. Now, Shakti is married to Reena.
There is another Reena.
Shakti is married to Reena, and two children, Subhash and Reshma, are born.
They are married. Subhash, Reshma.
Subhash and Reshma are born. How Aarti is related to Shruti?
Where is Aarti? Here is Aarti. And where is Shruti? Here is Shruti. Now,
how Aarti is related to Shruti? Let's find it out. Simply, Saurabh is the father of Madhav. We are not aware about whether Saurabh is a male or a female. We just can't assume anything. But Saurabh is a parent of Shruti. And these two are siblings. Right? Obviously, Aarti should be aunt or uncle of Shruti. So, simply, the answer is D. Aunt. She is the aunt of Shruti. Aunt. Answer. That's it. Give it a look to that table, that graph. Give it a look. I need a glass of water. Clear. I hope you can pause that video, but I need to drink a glass of water. I hope all these questions are clear to you. Basically, the main motive of making this shortcut video. Making the concept video was to explain how to solve the blood relation questions. I have seen in many books, I have seen many teachers are, you know, explaining this chapter and without any technique to solve the, you know, these questions. They try to, you know, they tell you to solve the blood relation questions in your mind. They give a, you know, ridiculous kind of graphs. There is no plus minus kind of whenever you make a graph, at the end of making the graph, you are unable to find out is A the brother of B or is A is the wife of B. You need to go back to the whole puzzle. In case of a big puzzle, you need to go back to the puzzle and check out, yeah, she's a wife, she's not the sister. So in case of a big puzzle, you can't go back to the puzzle again and again. Once you have gone through that puzzle, forget about it. You have just made your graph and you need to solve the question from that graph only. In case of a puzzle of 5 questions, you can solve that puzzle by practice within 5 to 6 minutes, you know. But in case you need to read the puzzle again and again, then you just even can't solve that puzzle in 10, 12, even 15 minutes. So try to follow this technique. Let's do the last question in this lecture. In a family, there are 7 persons comprising of 2 married couples. T is the son of M. T is the son of M. We got that T is a male. T is the son of M and grandson of K. M is a widower. M and R are brothers. We got that M and R are male. And W is a daughter-in-law of J. We need to make another graph because the people are new here. There is a person J. He is having a son. He or she is having a son. Who's having a wife who has been married to W, who's a female. W is a daughter-in-law of J. Who is the mother of R? Brothers. W is a daughter-in-law of J. W is a daughter-in-law of J. J is the mother of R. J, who's the mother of R? Who is the mother of R? J is a female, we got that. That is a confusing point. M and R are brothers. W is a daughter-in-law of J. And J is the mother of R. J is a female and grandmother of D. And grandmother of D, there is a next generation here of maybe grandmother of D and grandmother of D. Now we need to, you know, combine these two graphs. R is the common person here, obviously R is plus here. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We are aware about these 7 people. Obviously, this blank situation should be the R, because that's why in the question they clearly mentioned that there are 7 persons and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There is no place for this, you know, blank. So it should be R, right? And J is the mother of R. J is the mother of R. And W is the wife. Let's rub it. We don't need this graph anymore. Very easy. W is a wife. Then there was a daughter, D. Now D is related. How D is related to M?
how D is related to M.
D is a daughter of R. And M is a brother of R. So how they're related? Obviously, the D, M is the uncle of D. Or, you know, if D is a male, he's a nephew of M. Or if she's a, if D is a female, then she's a niece. So the answer is C, nephew, simple. We need to find out the relation between M and D. There's a generation gap and R is a father and these two are brothers, obviously. He's uncle, M is uncle, and D is a nephew or niece. So that's all for today. I'm going to provide a link to the practice questions and you can click the link here. You can go to the GK Digest Android app. I'm going to, you know, upload lots of new techniques, tricks on that app. And I'm going to upload a lot of ebooks on that app. That's all for today. You can like a YouTube channel on youtube.com/bankexamstoday. Like the channel, subscribe our channel, you know, give 5-star rating to our Android app GK Digest on Play Store. That's all for today. Bye.